Hi children, today we will start a new lesson comparing quantities. So in our daily life we come across so many situations we need to compare two quantities, is it? So in your class 6 you already learned to compare two quantities by means of ratio and proportion. So in this lesson we will discuss about ratio and proportion and we will study a new method for comparison, that is percentage. Okay children, so first we will discuss ratio and proportion. So what do you mean by ratio? We know that ratio is a method of comparing two or more quantities of the same kind, that's very important, of the same kind by division. So what do you mean by ratio? Ratio is the method of comparing two or more quantities of the same kind. Same kind means the unit must be same. Okay, same kind by division. This we already learned in your class 6. And we denoted ratio, we are used denoted by the symbol is two symbol, is it? Ratio we are representing by using the symbol. Ratio is denoted by using the symbol is two. Okay. And we will read it as is two. Okay children, so ratio means what? Ratio means how you can generalize if A and B are two quantities of the same kind. Same kind means same unit. Okay, then the fraction A by B is called the ratio of A to B. So is the form A by B, that means what? A is to B. This is the ratio where A and B are integers and B not equal to 0. Okay children, so that's very important that if you want to compare two quantities, the unit must be same. If you want to find out the ratio of two quantities, the unit must be same. That's very important. Ratio is a method of comparing two or more quantities by division. Okay, and the unit must be same. Okay children, now ratio A is to B is not same as B is to A. That means A is to B, the ratio A is to B and B is to A is different. Okay, that same thing, A by B is not equal to B by A. For example, we can take 1 by 3 is not equal to 3 by 1. So the fraction 1 by 3 is not equal to 3 by 1. So what we can say, the ratio A is to B is not equal to B is to A. Okay, now look at one example. Find the ratio of 3 kilometer to 300 meter. Find the ratio of 3 kilometer to 300 meter. I told you if you want to find out the ratio, the most important thing is the unit must be same. Here one is in kilometer and one is in meter. So first we will convert kilometer to meter. 3 kilometer means what? 3 kilometer means 3000 meter. 3 kilometer means 3000 meter. So how will we find the ratio? 3 kilometer is to 300 meter means what? 3000 by 300. So what is the answer? 30 by 3, that's equal to 10 by 1. So what is the ratio? 10 is to 1. So what is the required ratio? 10 is to 1. So the important thing is if you want to find out the ratio of two quantities, the unit must be same. Okay, now equivalent ratio, how will we find equivalent ratios? Equivalent ratio is same as finding equivalent fraction. So two ratios are called equivalent if the fraction corresponding to them are equivalent. We already studied how to find equivalent fraction of a given fraction. How will we find equivalent fraction? Either by multiplying or dividing a same number to the numerator and denominator, you will get the equivalent fraction. So the same method for finding equivalent ratios, what we have to do, just convert them into fraction and find out the equivalent fraction, that will be the equivalent ratios. I hope it's clear. Now we can say that 2 is to 7 is equivalent to 4 is to 14. That means 2 by 7 is equivalent to 4 by 14. We multiplied a same number to the numerator and we got the equivalent ratio. So what we can say, 2 is to 7 is same as 4 is to 14, two equivalent ratios. Okay, like the same way 3 is to 11 is equivalent to 6 is to 22. So this ratio and this ratio are equivalent, that means they are equal. Okay, so for finding the equivalent ratio, what you have to do, just convert them into fraction, just write the fraction form, write the fraction form and write, find out the equivalent fraction, that will be the equivalent ratio. Okay children, now comparison of ratio. Comparison of ratio is same as comparison of fraction. So as a ratio is a fraction, we compare two ratios by the method of comparing fraction. We already studied how to compare two fractions in our fraction lesson, is it? So to compare 7 is to 9 and 5 is to 9, what you have to do children? We have to compare 7 by 9 and 5 by 9. 7 by 9 and 5 by 9, which one is greater? We know that 7 by 9 is greater because they are like fractions. So if they are like fractions, the fraction having greater numerator will be the greatest fraction. So what we can say, this is greater than this ratio. Okay, 7 is to 9 is greater than 5 is to 9. So for comparing or for finding equivalent ratios, just do the same method as we did for fraction. Okay, just write the fraction form, find out the equivalent fraction if you want equivalent ratio. So if you want to compare two ratio, compare the fraction, we can compare the ratio. Okay children, now the next important topic we have to learn, that means we already learned this proportion. What do you mean by proportion? Proportion means what? Two equal ratios. Proportion means two equal ratios. Suppose if A by B is equal to C by D. A by B is equal to C by D. That means if two ratios are equal, we can say that ABCD are in proportion. ABCD are in proportion. ABCD are in proportion. If two ratios, if two equal ratios, or you can write A is to B is equal to C is to D. If two ratios are equal, we can say they are in proportion. So also written as A is to B is same as C is to D. It is also written as A is to B same as C is to D. And here this A and D, listen children, here this A and D are called extreme terms. Extreme terms. This also we learned in last year. Extreme terms. And A and D are called extreme terms and B and C are called middle terms. Okay, A and D are called extreme terms and B and C are called middle terms. And if the product of extremes, listen children, if the product of extremes, that means A into D, if the product of extremes is equal to product of middle terms, that is B into C, so we can say that the given numbers are in proportion. If the product of extremes is equal to product of middle terms, we can say that they are in proportion. I will show you one example. So proportion means what? Two equal ratios. So if A is to B is same as C is to D, if and only if AD is equal to BC, that means if the product of extremes is equal to product of middle terms, we can say that they are in proportion. So if the product of extremes is not equal to AD, means A into D. If the product of extremes is not equal to product of middle terms, what you can say? They are not in proportion. Okay children, I'll give you one example. Are the ratios 25 centimeter to 30 centimeter and 40 kilogram to 48 gram in proportion? There are two methods of finding this answer. The first method, this is the first method. First method, you write the fraction form of the ratio, and we know that always we have to express ratio in its lowest term. We have to express ratio in its lowest term. And how will we find the lowest term of a fraction? We know that by finding the HCF of the numerator and denominator and divide by using the HCF, you will get the lowest term of the particular fraction. Now what is the HCF of 25 and 30? HCF of 25 and 30 will be 5. So what is the answer you will get? 5 by 6, that is same as 5 is to 6. Like the same way, this fraction also you express in slowest term. 40 divided by what will be the HCF between 40 and 48? HCF between 40 and 48 will be 8. So what is the answer? 40 divided by 8 is 5. 48 divided by 8 is 6. So what is the answer? 5 is to 6. So what is the answer we got? Two ratios having the same answer you got. So what you can say, children, the given ratios, what you can say? 25 is to 30 and 40 is to 48 are in proportion. This is the first method for finding to form whether they are in proportion or not. Okay, and one more method. What is the first method? First you write the fraction form of the ratio and find the lowest term. If the lowest term is equal, we can say that they are in proportion. This is one method for finding they are in proportion. And the next method, the same question we will do by using second method. Okay, this is the second method. If the product of the extreme means what? First term and the last term. That means 25 into 48. 25 into 48, what is the answer? 1200. Like that, same way, 30 into 40, product of middle terms, what is the answer? 1200. If the product of extreme terms is equal to product of middle terms, we can say that the four numbers are in proportion. The given ratios form a proportion, or we can write it as 25 is to 30 is same as 40 is to 48. I hope it's clear. So if you want to check whether they are in proportion or not, there are two methods. Either you convert the ratio into fraction, find the lowest term. If the answers are same, we can say that the given ratios are in proportion. Or the second method. What is second method? Find out the product of extreme terms and product of middle terms. If the answers are same, if the product of extreme terms is equal to product of middle terms, we can say that the given ratios are in proportion, and we can write this as 25 is to 30 is same as 40 is to 48. I hope it's clear regarding ratio and proportion. We already studied this in your class 6. Just recall everything one more time. That's all for today. Thank you.